Hello friends, welcome to my channel Power BI Skills. In our today's video, we'll be discussing about drill through function in Power BI. Drill through is very simple but very effective feature in Power BI. Let's understand with the help of example that how it works. In this example, we have a sales data set showing the sales made by a salesman, the product they have sold, and the state in which the sales is made. And we have a sales amount as well. So we'll directly upload this data set in Power BI and see how this drill through function works. Before we proceed further, I would like to request you to share my video and like my video and subscribe this channel in case you believe that you have gained some knowledge through this video. Thank you. Now let's proceed further. So here we have uploaded the data set in Power BI. So all these fields are now uploaded. Now straight away move to the report view. And we'll first create a column visual. Let's go to new visual. And I will straight away add data. I'll add sales. And let's add name of the salesman. I will change this bar chart to column chart.
Yes.
This column visual is ready. I will just format this. I'll go to view, go to format. Now you can see my format option is appearing on the right hand side. I'll click on this. Let's change the title to Sales by Salesman. I'll bold this, increase the size to 20, and centerline this. I'll enable the data labels, change the color to purple. Now let's create another visual. But before that, I will add the visual borders as well. For that, I'll go to size and style. I will go to visual borders and enable the visual border. Now let's create another visual, which is our donut chart visual. I will go to home, new visual, and I'll create the donut chart. I'll select the donut chart visual from the drop down. Here in legend, I will add product name, and in values, I will add sales. Now we have sales by product visual ready. I will do the formatting, go to format. I will change the title to sales by product, bold. I will increase the font size to 20, aligning it towards the center. So now we have these two visuals ready. I will enable the visual borders here as well. Okay. So friends, in my previous video, we have covered hierarchies where I had discussed about the drill up and drill down functionality. Through customized hierarchy, we can enable drill up and drill down functionality. If you have not seen my video, I have shared the link. You can see the link here on the screen where I have explained about the customized hierarchy and the drill up and drill down feature. So you can refer to that video. In this video, we'll be specifically discussing about the drill through feature. So drill through feature is useful where the users will have to see the details at a granular level. So we want to see at a transactional level, like what transactions are done. So let me explain you by creating the drill through visual. So for that, I will go to the next tab. Here, I will create a table. So I'll go to new visual and I'll select a table here. I will add data. I'll start with date. In date, I will remove quarter. I don't need that. I will add the sales manager name. I will add the name of the salesman. I will add product name. State where sale is done. And finally, the sales amount. So this is the table which we have created. Let me align it towards the center. And I will format this table. I will go to size and style. I will enable the visual border. I will add the title here. I'll write sales detailed. Sales report. I will bold this and align it towards the center. Now I'll go to style presets, and from the drop down I'll select sparse. So this table is ready. Now, I will go to format and page information. In page information, I'll first name this tab as detailed report. The moment I name this tab here, you can see the tab name over here is also appearing as detailed report. And on the page type, I will select drill through. Now, this is the detailed report or a drill through report. I will have to give some parameter like at what level we have to do the drill through. So here I will have to add data. So I will add the data as sales. So I'll go to data. And I'll add sales. So you would have observed moment I have added the drill through from as sales, there is a button which is appearing here, the back button. So we will come to this later. First, we will go to our first tab, which is page one. And now I have to insert a button. I'll go to drop down and select a blank button. I'll place it here. And now I will go to button option in format. And at the bottom, I have a option action. I will enable this. Now this will enable my button. I will go to drop down. From the type, I will select drill through. Destination would be my detailed report, which is the next tab. I will go to the button style. I'll first select the button style to disabled. I'll enable the text, enter detailed report. I'll increase the size to 12, bold this, and I will change the font size from gray to black so that it is clearly visible. I'll go to shape. I need a rounded corner for this button, so I will change the to rounded corner and make it to 15 points. I will enable fill and add color. Let's say I'll add color to green. So, okay. So you would have seen that from the button style, I have selected the state as disabled. So when this button is disabled, it would appear in green and it would show the detailed report here. I would also add a tooltip. When the button is disabled, then this would show a message or a text when we hover on this button that clicks. To click here to get the detailed report. So you can see that it is appearing this. Now this button would not work because this is disabled. So to enable the button, we have to first select any of the details, like we select either a salesman or we have to select a product type or product name to enable the button. So you can see that when we select either the salesman's column or any of the product, then this button enables. So we have to change the setting when button gets enabled as well. So in the similar way, the way we did it for when the button was disabled, I'll do the same for when the button gets enabled. So for that, I'll go to button setting again. I'll select this button. I'll go to button style. Now from the state, instead of disabled, I'll select the default. Shape would again be a rectangle. Corners, I need around it, 15. Text would be same, detailed report. Bold. Color would be black. And in fill, I would select gray. So when this button would be enabled, the color would change to gray. The rest of the things would remain same. Now the button is ready. So it is in the disabled state because it is appearing in gray. And when I select any of the salesmen, let's say if I select Jerry, you can see the button color changes to gray. It means this button is now activated. I'll have to press Control and then click to go to detailed report. So since I had selected Jerry, this report is showing me all the details of salesman Jerry. What sales done by Jerry, all these details for Jerry is appearing here. Now, if I have to go back, I'll click on the back button by pressing Control and the mouse key. I'll be back to my originals report. Now, if I want to see the details for, let's say, chocolates, I'll select chocolates from this donor chart. Moment I select chocolate, again, the button color turns gray. It means this button is activated. I'll press Control and mouse key on the button to go to the detailed report. Here I can see the detailed report of chocolate sales. So friends, you would have observed that how simple it is to enable the drill-through functionality in your report. And again, as I mentioned, that this would be very useful when we have to analyze the data at a granular level, when we have to see the transaction level information. So that we can incorporate in our report and dashboard through enabling the drill-through option and adding the drill-through button. I hope you understood how to apply the features in our reports and dashboard, and you will be able to implement the same in your reports. Thanks for watching, friend. If you have any questions or comment relating to the feature, you can put your comment and I would reply to your comment. Thank you so much. Bye-bye. Take care.